Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the vlog. My name is Darren. I'm an outdoor photographer. I'm based here in beautiful Ireland. And today I want to talk about one of the most important yet challenging aspects of landscape photography, and that is finding the perfect location. You see, it's not just about stumbling upon great views. It takes planning, patience, and sometimes a lot of research to find that perfect shot. So let's jump into exactly why I think I can help you with this challenge. Now, one of the first challenges you'll face is overcrowding. So popular spots like in Iceland, I suppose Skógafoss, or even here in Ireland, the Cliffs of Moher, they're beautiful, but they can get packed with tourists. And when you're trying to capture an absolutely stunning landscape, having a crowd of people in the shot isn't exactly ideal. So to avoid this, try visiting these locations at off-peak times. So obviously early in the morning or late evening are your best bets. Now, sunrise shoots in particular, they give you the advantage of fewer people, and some would also argue better light. Now, as well, if possible, look for lesser known spots near to these popular locations. Sometimes the hidden gems nearby can offer just as much beauty without the crowds. Now, when you look at seasons, summertime here in Ireland is extremely busy. So a great opportunity for me is to be able to go outside of summer. I've got a lot less people and I generally have the place all to myself. That allows me to take my time, find my shots, and find the perfect composition from a well-known location that I can call my own. Now, finding a good location often starts with research, and the likes of social media platforms and Instagram, they're great for inspiration, and they can also lead to oversaturation. So, which means that everybody ends up going to exactly the same spots. So, instead, try using Google Earth to explore areas virtually before you go. Now, this gives you a sense of terrain and also allows you to plan ahead for different shooting angles. Now, local photography blogs, forums, or even talking to locals can give you insights into places that aren't flooded with tourists. Now, this is why I created my photography location guides, because I've gone out there, I've found the locations, I've done the research to help you save time and be able to go and get those shots. But when you're there, go and have a look close by as well, because when you start looking at Google Maps, which is I've done on a number of occasions, you'll spot something that will catch your eye. And then it's about looking at the map, following the map, and finding that location. Even after doing all of your research, there's no substitute for physically scouting the location. Now, my advice would be get there ahead of time and walk around and explore different vantage points. This will give you a much better feel of how the light interacts with the landscape and what elements will enhance your composition. Now, when scouting as well, also look out for things like natural leading lines or interesting foregrounds or unique features that can make your shot stand out. And don't forget, consider the weather. It can be completely changing the mood of your shots and the scene at a moment's notice. Now, I've done another episode specifically about the weather, and if you haven't seen that episode in this series, I'll link to it up here. But the weather can make or break your shot. So be understanding of what the weather can do, but more importantly, go find the location, get your feet on the ground, and start walking around. And another bit of advice is do not bring out your tripod right away. Have the camera in your hand, find different elevations, different compositions, and then and only then, once you've got an idea in your head and it's now in the camera, then set up your tripod to lock that shot into place, and then you can start playing with your technical aspects. Now, Now, it's important to note as well that the same location can look completely different depending on the time of year or the angle of the sun. So, for example, a location that's perfect for sunset in summer might not work as well in winter when the sun sets in a completely different angle. Now, planning tools like the photographer's emphorus or another which I've recently started to use, which is Sun Surveyor, can help you figure out where the light will be at different times of the day and, of course, of the year. Now, this kind of planning can make a big difference in how your photos turn out. The important thing here is that when you're starting to look at these apps, learn them, practice them, learn them, practice them. You're not going to get it right day one, but the more you use it, the quicker you can access the menus and the quicker you'll be able to find out exactly how the light is going to hit the landscape at a different time of the year. Now, on the coast of Ireland here, the west coast is always good for sunset, but when I go photographing down in Waterford as an example, in the summertime, the sun will actually rise behind the headland, whereas in the winter, the sun will rise in my image, and the same goes for sunset. So you get a completely different lay of light and you get totally different conditions and shots. Now, of course, some of the best landscape locations are remote and, of course, are difficult to reach. You might have to hike for hours or drive on rough roads or climb steep terrain. Now, while that sense of adventure is really exciting, it's also important to be safe. Always be prepared. Bring the right gear, wear the proper footwear, carry enough supplies, and lots of water. Research the terrain ahead of time and know exactly what kind of conditions you'll be facing. And remember, if a location feels too dangerous to reach, then it's okay to reconsider. Safety should always come first. Don't put yourself in the position of actually in harm's way just to get that shot. I've seen it far too often where people will scramble over rocks because they'll believe that there'll be a shot there, they'll make it, but the shot wasn't there. So assess the situation beforehand, and if you don't feel comfortable, it's okay. You don't have to force yourself to get to that spot. It may not even be worth it in the end. Now, not every great landscape photo comes from a famous location. As I've mentioned earlier, when you find something different in a known location, it can really elevate your shot. Now, equally, sometimes ordinary places like a local field or park can provide the perfect setting for an amazing shot. It all comes down to just how you use the light, the composition and colour. So look for interesting textures, patterns or leading lines, and even the most basic scene can be transformed with the right perspective and, of course, conditions. Once you've done this, then you know that you can apply those skills when you're out in the field at different locations. There's nothing worse than you knowing that you're going to go to a location and you're not ready for the changing light. So your local area can really help you to be able to practice, dial in those settings at a quick moment's notice to be able to bag that shot. So the next time that you're planning a landscape photography shoot, remember that finding the perfect location isn't just about luck. It takes research, scouting, and sometimes stepping off the beaten path to find the best shots. And don't forget, sometimes the journey itself is as equally rewarding as the final image. Now, that sounds cliche, but it is actually very true. If you are fixed on getting to an end spot, don't forget that there could be shots that you will spot along the way that you can also get shots on the way back. So thank you very much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please make sure to give me a like, a comment, and if you made it this far, I'd really appreciate if you hit the subscribe button. Let me know in the comments about your favorite locations to shoot and how you found them. Thank you very much, everybody. See you on the next one. Schlange Fall.